every century has a legacy. And I was telling them the legacy of the 20th century is the scientific development. He went from unbelievable. I mean, remember that in 1903, the Wright brothers flew for the first time. So, and but also the legacy of the 20th century is that for the first time in history, humans developed the ability to destroy all kinds of life on Earth and atomic bomb, these kind of crazy things. So I thought the 21st century is going to be taking us to the basics, not to the outside world, but the inside world, and to make peace, inner peace. So the paradigm is not going to be success, but happiness. And happiness is an spiritual concept, and it has to be with your inner peace and peace among human beings. Because there will be bombs exploding all over the place. I mean, I saw many times people killed on the streets. I saw people being killed, but I saw bodies in the mornings several times. And Pablo Escobar was totally crazy. I mean, he was an evil but a crazy man. I don't know how much is his fault, but it's crazy. So I went to live in Buga Valle. I went to live in another city. I got offered a job, some manager for an important company, and I decided I wanted to go because I wanted to leave Medellin because of the risk of any of my kids being, you know, blown up in any moment. So the fifth International Conference on Nonviolence was held in Medellin, April 23 to 26, 2003. The Sunday before the conference, Guillermo Gaviria was kidnapped. He couldn't attend, and then he was killed over almost 13 months later. He knew he could be killed. And he also in the diary, he sent a letter to his father when he was in captivity, explaining why he took that big chance. But he never complained. If you read his diary, he never complains about that. He says, I am more convinced than ever about the power of nonviolence. And when he was killed, I was really devastated. I mean, I cried. I think I have never cried before. I mean, I was devastated. But his legacy is still alive. I don't know if you know that there is this peace agreement in Colombia. And we went to the town of Caicedo like a month ago with the FARC leaders, who are now members of the Congress, because they wanted to complete the march. They had stopped. And they want to ask for forgiveness to the people of nonviolence. Is in the same direction as evolution. Evolution is a force that is taking us up. It's from the one single cell to human beings, and it's still going. And evolution is about raising up the level of conscience. And nonviolence is in the same direction. I mean, it's just a matter of time. I always say, Dr. King said, we have to learn to live together as brothers and sisters, or we will perish together as fools. So far, the evidence is like telling us that we are going to perish together as fools, but I think the power of love will say the last word. And if we are going to survive, it's going to be to nonviolence, brotherhood, and maternal thinking. So domestic violence produces 3 times the killings than the war. And domestic violence is mostly on women and children.
Yeah.
In Colombia, every day, more than one woman is killed by her partner. The one is supposed to love her. And I say that the only possibility we have is that we have to take nonviolence seriously. And the only way to take it seriously, you have to make the teaching of nonviolence mandatory at every single level of educational system. Spirituality is something that is available to everyone, and it's the ability to create inner peace at any moment. Try to be as good at that as possible, and you will be in control of your life. And understand that violence is the denial of intelligence, because when you use violence, you are leaving out the capacity to think and to speak. That is what distinguishes human beings from animals. If you do that, you may have a kind of difficult life, you will have a happy life, and you will grow happier and happier, but you will see there is a match between what you are doing and you were meant to do.